It's Levack and Goss on 104.5 The Team.
Live from O'Toole's, getting ready for a big event tomorrow. We are lucky to be joined by Izzy Gutierrez, of course, from Around the Horn, NBA columnist for ESPN.com. Izzy, I'm going to throw you right into what has been the most contentious fight between Goss and I. Are the Knicks better without Carmelo Anthony?
Well, let's first remember, where did they start off last year? It wasn't bad. Like, I think they might have started off 7-4 or something like that. But they started off pretty decently. This year, I think they're better without Mookie, essentially because they're a younger, more dynamic player, more of the attention, more of the opportunities. Just that for drinking that Carmelo have, obviously. And, you know, what's working out is that offense. And, you know, they're maybe playing a little bit harder than they were last year. There was a lot of swing from that team last year. And so, yeah, I think they're probably a little bit better, sure.
No, that's the wrong answer. For someone who's from Syracuse, that hurts me a little bit, Izzy. I'll ask you this question, though. I'll let you off the hook because we like you. I'll let you off the hook. Can the Knicks continue this pace and maybe potentially be a playoff team as soon as this season?
Listen, I'm not going to rule out anybody making the playoffs in the Eastern Conference just yet, especially a team that's starting off this way. I think it would be good for them. Obviously, I think it would be good for the league if they rebounded here. And I think it would really just reset that franchise in terms of saying, okay, look, we were in a messy situation. We got out of it cleanly, and apparently we got out of it correctly at the right time, and we're going the right direction, and you sort of restart that fan base and make them forget about Carmelo. Can they do it? Sure. But there's some teams out there, Detroit, Philly, Miami, if they heat up again in the second half, like, they can fill up those top eight spots really quickly. But I do think that, you know, they've got potential.
Izzy Gutierrez with us right now on Levack and Goss, 104.5 The Team. Boston goes out and makes the Warriors look human last night. Are they now the team to beat in the East?
No. I'm not ready to give up on any LeBron James-led team, especially when you consider the way he's been playing offensively lately and not even having a full training camp to work with. I think he's only going to get better, and so that team is probably still to be reckoned with. That team is probably still going to make some roster choices that will improve them, I would think, as the season goes along. And, yeah, I mean, currently you win this many games in a row, it's kind of hard to argue that they're that good, but they really are. I just can't really say they're the favorites right now. They just kind of got into their rhythm early. They got, even though they only have four returning players from last year, they've got some continuity there with their core. And so I think Brad Stevens and that group of motivated players, I mean, there's a lot of motivated players in that team. Jaylen Brown's a really good guy. Jason Tatum's a really good dude, and they're young and hungry. And so I think Boston is, I would not be shocked one bit if they continue to improve and eventually make the finals, but I wouldn't pick them yet.
Kevin Durant and Russell Westbrook don't like each other. Can we just get to the point where LeBron and Kyrie admit it, that they don't like each other, and we get a real rivalry in the Eastern Conference?
No, I don't think you'll ever get there. I know LeBron will never really admit that, if it's even true. I think, not that I've flipped on Kyrie, but I definitely have gotten to know him better, I think, just in terms of, you know, what he says, what he's done, and, you know, having talked to him a couple of times since the season started. I think, I don't know if he dislikes LeBron. I just think he's his own man. Like, really, really honestly, what he's saying is that, you know, you see the landscape, you see the future, and it's not best for me. And I'm not going to bank my future on somebody else's, you know, leadership or somebody else's decisions. And Kyrie is a smart kid, despite the flat earth theory. Is a smart kid and knows, you know, what he can learn from LeBron and take it over to Boston. So I do think that he just made a good decision for him. It just wasn't a very good basketball decision for LeBron, and he probably is a little kicked off.
Izzy Gutierrez with us. Izzy, SportsCenter might have created this question for me. As every time LeBron has a breakaway dunk and Jordan's on the sideline, he, like, stares dead down Jordan. Is there a charity or a something big enough that we could actually see a one-on-one half-court game, even if it's just horse, between Jordan and LeBron?
Oh, man, I would pay not to see that. I'd like to remember Jordan when he was a good athlete because that would be That would be a disaster to watch.
Izzy, let's get an around the horn. Congratulations, by the way, on the 100th career victory. I know that's a fantastic accomplishment. Take us behind the scenes. What maybe is the viewer of Around the Horn not realized that goes into the show, that's some cool stuff we might learn today about the show?
Well, let me ask you this. Is it really a cool accomplishment? It just means I've been on the show a lot.
Yes, of course.
The scoring system is not really a system, and it's almost literally, here's something that, a little inside information, Tony Reale very much likes to keep the winning percentages at around 25% for every panelist, and so it's not really a matter of how stars are.
Izzy Gutierrez with us right now, and we got this weird delay. Izzy, we apologize for that. We're live from one of our local hangs, O'Toole's, and there's a thing called Bacon Bash tomorrow. Is there any food on the planet that's actually better than bacon?
I'm sorry, say that one more time. Is there any what?
Is there any food on the planet better than bacon?
I will sort of maybe like make that greater or grander and call it cured pork, I guess. Like that kind of meat is probably the best. I'm not sure there's anything better than bacon, but and in particular, if people don't know this, they should look it up. Benton's Bacon, Benton apostrophe S Bacon, the best bacon in the world. You can buy it on the internet. Just go get it.
Ooh, all right. See, okay. You learn something new every day. Izzy, we appreciate you. Sorry for the weird delay, and thanks for living through it with us and answering some great questions.
And do 100 more wins and around the horn.
Yeah, you can have me back on in my 200th win. It'll be about 5 years from now.
Izzy, thank you so much, man. Have a great day. Izzy Gutierrez right there. One of the absolute best. Absolutely, no doubt about that.